Hey, what's going on, guys? Daniel from ModBot, and today I'm going to show you how I built this really inexpensive UV curing station for my resin 3D print. So let's get into it. My goal was to make something compact and relatively inexpensive. So the three things you'll need is a paint bucket. I just went down to Home Depot and picked up a gallon empty paint bucket for a few dollars. You'll need some foil tape. Also got this from Home Depot as well. This is way too much, but I've got enough for 10 of these things now. As well as some UV LEDs. I picked up a roll in the power supply off Amazon. I think it was roughly $16, but I'll link you guys in the description down below. And these LEDs have seemed to work out pretty well. So if you want to get the same ones as me, again, I'll link you guys down below. So initially, I was planning on wrapping the foil tape kind of inwardly round inside the paint bucket, but the way the foil tape works when you peel it, it likes to roll around itself and is pretty fragile. So I started off with making really long length tapes, and what I ended up doing was just cutting them in half after the fact and doing them where I basically reached in, put one end of the foil tape on the bottom of the bucket, and then used my hand to kind of remove any bubbles or creases, and peeled towards the top. And then once I was at the top, I then pushed to tear the foil tape and then just kind of rip off the excess stuff on top. You definitely don't have to be too careful. Worst comes to worst, you just overlap some more tape, but kind of that's what you're going for right there, is just a smooth as possible surface of the foil tape along the sides. So this will take you a while. I rinsed and repeated. I probably could have done it a bit quicker, but I'd say all in all, it was probably somewhere around 15 to 20 minutes of just laying down these pieces of foil and slowly working my way around the bucket until I had completely covered everything. And I kind of got a technique down in the end where I'd peel a little bit, place it on the bucket, and then pull it off, because again, the biggest issue I was running into was that this tape likes to roll and then stick to itself, which can be pretty frustrating. So for me, that's what worked the best, was to peel a corner, stick it to the top of the bucket, peel the rest, and grab it with my hand to not give it a chance to roll around itself. You'll see what I'm talking about if you do this. You kind of start to see what's not working and then build your technique around that, but again, that's what worked out for me. And once I was done with all of the edges, like so, then I just went ahead and placed some strips on the bottom. Again, didn't really have much of a technique, just peeled probably five or six pieces and pushed as much as I could around the bottom corners to get rid of any creases, and this was the end result, which I was really happy with. So then you want to take your LEDs and unspool them. So you have a couple options here. I went ahead and drilled a hole in the bottom of the bucket to feed the plug through. Essentially, you could just have the plug dangling over the top of the bucket. I figured for adhesion purposes and kind of cleanliness, it would look nicer to have it feeding out the bottom. But be very careful if you're drilling into this bucket, because when you drill, it's almost like a basically an aluminum can. So there will be shards, and it's very easy to potentially cut yourself. So if you do drill out like I did a hole in the bottom, I'd recommend like either getting some kind of like a rubber gasket or something to basically go into the hole, just to protect one, yourself if you end up touching that, into the cable from getting sheared or cut if it's pulled up against that that kind of filleted edge there. And my technique with this, it was really hard to get on camera, but essentially I stuck it on the bottom, and I just peeled away the backing of the LEDs ever so slowly as I made my way around. And I didn't measure out an exact spacing. I'd say it was something like a centimeter, give or take, between each round of LEDs. But really, my goal was just to try to fill up as much of the bucket as possible, and overall I think I did a really good job of that, and this was the end result, which I was, again, incredibly happy with. It's been taking roughly 20 minutes on each side for most parts, and for bigger parts that are full, I'll usually leave them in for about 45 minutes to an hour and then flip them over and do another 45 minutes to an hour. But This has been much better than just using the sun. Before, I was sticking the parts either outside or in the windowsill, but with how it's been kind of cloudy lately, and it was just taking a lot longer, so it's a lot nicer having kind of a controlled setup. So anyways, guys, this is a really cheap solution, roughly like 30 bucks on how to build your own UV curing station. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and maybe this will at least inspire you on how you can make your own. If you've got any questions, let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos. See you guys in my next video.